People listen. I had given the assignment, and that was supposed to be completed by using all those springboard tools which we had discussed and implemented during our sessions, and it was expected that you guys will solve and upload. I had given on WhatsApp as well as I had given on this message box. Had anyone tried doing? If anyone, do you have problem, you can ask me. It's very sad. Akshita, had you tried solving that assignment?
सर अभी असाइनमेंट नहीं स्टार्ट किया।
कब करेंगे? कोर्स वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड, नोबडी इज टेकिंग इंटरेस्ट, ऑलरेडी वी हैव कंप्लीटेड, व्हाट फॉर यू आर जॉइनिंग देन? And in the last class, you, I think you were absent also. I had integrated that applications.
Yes, sir. Sir, करनी पाई थी last की दो join.
उस दिन मैंने applications develop करके integrate भी किया था कि हम front end कैसे create करेंगे, back end कैसे create करेंगे, how do we integrate them?
Yes, sir. Videos भी नहीं उसकी शायद upload नहीं हुई थी.
उसकी code तो मैंने upload कर दी थी शायद. Let me just revise it just within 10 minutes. Just I am showing you and then I'll see whether it is uploaded or not. Uske baad main upload kar deta hu. Nobody even talked to me. Koi message bhi kisi ne nahi diya. Do you want me to? And after that only I had given the question of very simple application. Let's consider. I thought that you guys will implement, that is currency conversions. So in that I expect that there will be a simple interface what you need to create, and there you will enter the currency's value. Let's say in, let us assume that Indian currency you will enter and you wanted to convert that value into the foreign exchange currency's values, like in US how much dollar it will come, or Russian or any such countries. So you have to just pass two parameters, the amount and the currencies, and after conversions, and that information will be passed to the another microservice. That microservice will accept and return back those this thing result, and this is what I had demonstrated into the last to last session. Do you want me to show that applications running once again?
Sir, agar ho sake to karwa dijiye ek baar.
Okay, I'm just repeating, try to understand. In spite of I am having a high fever and taking all the drugs, already a few classes were disturbed because of my corona vaccination. So still I'm not quite well. In spite of all these hurdles, we are trying, but you guys are not so much interested in this corona time when you people should be more and more. You should take more and more interests, taking your own responsibilities. Though all these timings and current situation is very odd, let's launch the applications. I'm just recapping so that it will be helpful to you. Just wait, it takes a bit time to load. Because today I was expecting some of you will show me those things. Whenever you will think of creating my any applications using microservice, remember the first thing you have to create is Erica name server. Do you know why you have to create Erica name server? Just recall from your knowledge. Why the first microservice we are supposed to create is Erica name server? You can see here I have created also. Akshita, do you remember?
सर सारे माइक्रो सर्विसेज उसके अंडर आ जाते हैं फिर.
हाँ अंदर आ जाते हैं, सो दैट नेमिंग कॉन्वेंशंस के लिए हार्ड कोडिंग की जरूरत नहीं पड़ती है. सो ऑलवेज एनी माइक्रो सर्विस यू क्रिएट, द फर्स्ट थिंग कीप इन माइंड, क्रिएट एरे का नेम सर्वर. देन कोई भी एप्लीकेशंस के लिए एक फ्रंट एंड चाहिए ना काम करने के लिए जी. एनी एप्लीकेशंस के लिए एक फ्रंट एंड चाहिए. अभी तक हम लोग जो माइक्रो सर्विस, हम लोग जो माइक्रो सर्विसेस क्रिएट कर रहे थे, बेसिकली माइक्रो सर्विस जस्ट परफॉर्म्स द टास्क ऑफ एक्सेप्टिंग द सर्विस, डूइंग सम काइंड ऑफ कंप्यूटेशंस एट सर्वर एंड एंड रिटर्निंग बैक द रिजल्ट. Get the request, send the response. That's it. So the flexibility is that the front end needs to be created by different mechanism. There you can use HTML, CSS, AJAX, jQuery, any many other tools you can use. Now what I have done is that right now I have used the same MVC architecture of a Spring Boot, what the Java technology supports. So one thing, ये जो आप देख रहे हैं ना main module, this is also all our microservice. But main modules की task जो है mainly to create a screen, display. Let me just show you, then I shall explain it. So इसलिए मैंने उसका नाम दिया है मेन मॉड्यूल. सो लेट मी रन द मेन मॉड्यूल. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ऑलवेज एरिका नेम सर्वर हैज टू बी एग्जीक्यूटेड. तो सारे स्टेप्स को हम बता ही चुके हैं ऑलरेडी पहले से. लेट मी जस्ट एग्जीक्यूट. डिडंट रन. Okay, let's see. Close all this stuffs. Localhost 8761 port. Let me just see. On which port it is running? port. Yeah, it came. It takes a bit time to execute. So Erica name server is running. Let me interact with you first. Till this step, any confusion? Till running, till creating and running Erica name server?
No, sir.
You can see the previous videos. Next, once that is done, the second module is main module. Let me run it first, then you will understand. Okay. Let me run the main. Sorry, the main Java code, main module application. Let me run this second main application. This is also a microservice. Now, what type of microservice is this? Let me run first. On which port it is running? 9090. It just went off. No, this is another application screen. The main module is running at 9090. Let me just run 9090 localhost. See here. Now just see the screen and try to understand. Did you see this? I executed. Yes. The applications at port 9090 and having a very beautiful screen. This is the kind of integrations what I had done into the previous sessions, which you couldn't attend. So let's just, I'm just recapping. Understand how it came. Now today, you just try to understand what you are supposed to do. It is a view. So when you are creating applications like a thing, the complete, not only services, there has to be one service which needs to interact. And this is also a view that by using which we are just passing requests from one service to another. The common sense ki baat hai. Ye jo as a interface bhi act kar raha hai. Front end jisko hum bol sakte hain. For that I have used HTML, CSS. Kaise iske liye aapko JSP file create karna hai. Java server page. And this will be like client. Like for example, just see here. Here yahan pe hai na welcome, login, register and all. Just I am pressing register. See here. What happens? Register URL of running on port 9090s is displaying its screen. Ab prashn ye hai कि अभी तक ये काम तो हम लोगों ने किया कभी नहीं था. तो दिस इज वन एक्स्ट्रा वर्क यू हैव टू डू. लेट मी सी द, आई विल शो यू द कोड फर्स्ट. नाउ इफ यू आर क्रिएटिंग अ माइक्रो सर्विस विच हुज टास्क इज आल्सो टू क्रिएट व्यू, तो उसके लिए कुछ रिजिड स्ट्रक्चर है जो आपको फॉलो करना है. क्या करना है देखो, उसके लिए आपको जेएसपी क्रिएट करना है फॉर व्यूज. अभी तक हम लोग नहीं कर रहे थे और वो कहां होगा सो देख लो. इनसाइड एसआरसी, इनसाइड एसआरसी फोल्डर के अंदर मेन फोल्डर है. मेन फोल्डर के अंदर आपको वेव ऐप फोल्डर बनाना होगा और वेव ऐप फोल्डर के अंदर वेव आईएनएफ फोल्डर बनाना होगा. वेव आईएनएफ के अंदर व्यूज फोल्डर बनाना होगा. लुक एट दिस. These are all JSP files. आई समझ में बात. ये सारे JSP files है, that is actually views by using which we are displaying the contents which in the visible format with all beautifications. We are using all CSS and all. तो ये कहां रखते हैं, यहां पर. आई बात समझ में. ये कहां पे फोल्डर होगा, ये आपको क्रिएट करना होगा. कहां क्रिएट करेंगे, वेव आईएन, वेव ऐप बनेगा मेन के अंदर, फिर उसके अंदर वेव आईएनएफ होगा, फिर उसके अंदर व्यूज होगा एंड व्यूज विल कंटेन ऑल दिस जेएसपी फाइल्स. आपको स्क्रीन पे जो दिख रहा है ना, जस्ट लेट शो यू, अभी जो रजिस्टर दिख रही है, दिस रजिस्टर, दिस पेज, इस पेज को दिखाने का कोड कहां पे है, रजिस्टर डॉट जेएसपी के अंदर. लुक स्क्रीन पे आ रही है रजिस्टर डॉट जेएसपी. ये छोटी सी रजिस्टर डॉट जेएसपी है. एचटीएमएल फाइल्स. अब इसके अंदर जो आपका यूज हो रहा है, गौर से देखो, सीएसएस फाइल्स वगैरह. ये सीएसएस फाइल कहीं नहीं रखना है. इन सारे के लिए डायरेक्टरी स्ट्रक्चर इज वेरी रिजिड फॉर दिस फ्रेमवर्क. यू हैव टू फॉलो द सेम. और ऑल दिस सीएसएस फाइल, एक्सटर्नल फाइल, जावास्क्रिप्ट फाइल, ऑल दिस फाइल यू हैव टू प्लेस इनसाइड रिसोर्स के अंदर स्टैटिक फोल्डर पहले से बना हुआ है. जब आप प्रोजेक्ट क्रिएट करेंगे थ्रू स्प्रिंग आयो, स्टैटिक फोल्डर पहले से बना होगा, उसके अंदर आपको ये दो फोल्डर रख देना है, सीएसएस एंड इमेज फोल्डर, जिसमें सारी इमेज जो यूज हो रहा है पेज पे, ये मैं जार फाइल अपलोड कर चुका हूँ, आप गौर से देखो, मैं फिर से एक बार चेक भी कर लेता हूँ। तो ये स्ट्रक्चर इट इज मस्ट।
सर वीडियो नहीं अपलोड हुई?
नहीं, वीडियो शायद नहीं उस दिन डाउनलोड हो पाया था, वीडियो मैं अपलोड कर देता हूँ। एटलीस्ट स्टेप देख लो ना अभी, तो इजीली समझ में आ जाएगी। तो आप कोई भी एप्लीकेशंस बनाओगे तो फ्रंट एंड तो चाहिए ना। थ्रू दैट ओनली रिक्वेस्ट विल बी पास टू अनदर सर्विसेज एंड सो ऑन। तो इसलिए ये जो मैंने इसका जो नाम दिया मेन मॉड्यूल, मेन मॉड्यूल का काम मैंने रखा कि दिस इज ऑल्सो माइक्रो सर्विस। लेकिन ये कैसा माइक्रो सर्विस है ये जान लो। इसके दो टास्क है, वन टास्क टू क्रिएट व्यू एंड अनदर टास्क टू एक्सेप्ट योर डेटा रिक्वेस्ट एंड पास इट टू अनदर सर्वर, गेट बैक द रिजल्ट फ्रॉम अनदर सर्वर एंड डिस्प्ले यूजिंग व्यू। तो ये कैसा हो गया, क्लाइंट माइक्रो सर्विस हो गया ना। ओपन फेन क्लाइंट हम लोगों ने क्रिएट किया था ना, याद करो। सो दिस मेन मॉड्यूल इज बेसिकली फेन क्लाइंट टूल्स इट इज यूजिंग। तो मेनी टूल्स था ना माइक्रो सर्विसेज में, तो मेन फेन क्लाइंट जो है ओपन फेन दैट इज यूज्ड इनसाइड दिस मेन मॉड्यूल एंड ऑल द माइक्रो सर्विस हैज टू एग्जीक्यूट अंडर एडेका। सो इट इज हैविंग दैट डिपेंडेंसीज ऑल्सो। सो दिस क्लाइंट माइक्रो सर्विसेस का काम ये भी है इसके साथ साथ कि ये व्यू को दिखाए, और ये दिखाने के लिए आपको कुछ अदर डिपेंडेंसीज भी चाहिए, एंड वो डिपेंडेंसीज आपको आपको सेंट्रल रिपोजिटरी से डाउनलोड करना होगा दीज डिपेंडेंसीज। लुक एट दिस। तो यहां तो मैंने आपको एप्लीकेशंस क्रिएट कर दिया, ये फॉर्म फाइल जैसे ही लोगे, ये जो देख रहे हो JSTL यहां से यहां तक, और ये टॉम कैट। टू एग्जीक्यूट JSP यू नीड टू हैव दीज डिपेंडेंसीज, देन ओनली योर JSP पेज विल बी रेंडर्ड। तो देखो इसमें क्या क्या डिपेंडेंसी है, ऑल एप्लीकेशंस मस्ट बी ऑफ स्प्रिंग वेव, तो ये फर्स्ट तो ऑलवेज होता है। फिर देन इट इज एडुका क्लाइंट, under Eureka client it has to run OpenFame, got it? And apart from that, जो हम लोगों ने only last सत्र में देखा था, these are the dependencies has to be executed. Clear हुई? अब इसके बाद आपको configurations में जाके थोड़े changes करने हैं, I'll show you. ये स्ट्रक्चर तो समझ में आ गई, फोल्डर स्ट्रक्चर फॉर व्यू पेजेस SRC के अंदर, मेन के अंदर, रिसोर्सेज के अंदर स्टैटिक, ये इतना स्ट्रक्चर फोल्डर पहले से बना होगा। इसके अंदर यू हैव टू ऐड CSS फाइल्स इनसाइड CSS फोल्डर, इमेजेस फाइल इनसाइड इमेजेस फोल्डर, एंड JavaScript फाइल इनसाइड JS फोल्डर, ये बनाना है हमें। And apart from that, we have to create web app folder inside web app, web INF inside web INF views, and views will contain all the JSP file. Views will contain all the JSP file, remember. And each setting you have to perform inside resource applications properties. Look here. These are the three files. You have to specify using this that where is your views. तो याद करो हमारे views कहाँ थे, web INF के अंदर, views के अंदर। तो गौर से देखो, हम सिर्फ ये दो नहीं folder specify कर रहे हैं, we are not specifying web app. That means it is predefined into the framework that the folder's name must be web app. If you specify something else, it may not work. Remember, then all these files extensions will be .jsp. That is why I have written. Then there are certain static informations like CSS, JavaScript, and image file and all that we have specified inside resources. So it will search inside resource, and it will always search inside a static folder itself. So for that, for displaying JSP's views, we are having these three configurations parameter. That's all. If this much is done, let's see the application's code of main model. Look here, fin client enabling and enable flame clients, all that proxy servers jaoga. Because it is a client applications, it has to pass request to server. अब जैसे मैं आपको दिखाता हूँ, look here, मैंने यहाँ पे दो बटन आपके लिए बनाया है, register and register one. ये अभी आपके जो स्क्रीन पे दिख रहा है, ये हमारा fin client है. हमने जो स्प्रिंग बूट जब शुरू हुआ था तो दैट वाज द फर्स्ट स्टेप टू क्रिएट वन एप्लीकेशंस व्हिच कम्युनिकेट्स क्रिएटिंग स्प्रिंग बूट एप्लीकेशंस एंड एस्टैब्लिशिंग कम्युनिकेशंस विद अनदर वन एप्लीकेशन व्हिच सेंड्स रिक्वेस्ट टू अनदर तो रिक्वेस्ट ही बिकम्स द क्लाइंट एंड द एप्लीकेशंस टू हुम The first application is requesting become server. So the main module is a client applications. Let me just press the register button and wait. Can you see this error what you are getting? Because let me just go back. It is requesting to another microservice that but that microservice is down. This is the point which I am trying to show you that is another applications. And look, one thing you would have got in the first line itself, we are having fallback and last to last sessions before I had given you the assignment. You might be remembering the last tools what I had taught you, that was fallback. For handling fallback situations, we have tool Hystrix. So we need to improve this microservice applications, because when I am requesting to this service and that service is down, and in that case we are getting this ugly masses. In order to handle that, we should have used Hystrix, which I haven't used right now. I wanted to keep applications much simpler. But since I have taught that how we are using Hystrix, we can improve it easily. Let me just start this microservice to which it is requesting. Just to see the Eclipse. See, the user register microservice I have given the name. Let me execute user register. This is the service. Now let's execute. That service is running. Let's execute first. That service executed at port 9091. Let me just not start that service separately. See, Eureka server refresh. Look, Eureka server has given response. Two services are running. One is at 9091, that is main model. So this is a main model, is basically a client which does two tasks, displaying, having views, and requesting through views to the client, from client to server. And user register is basically a server which accepts request. Just press this. The space has come, so that is, it is executing. there is no default to display. If we would have had default, how do you add any defaults? Have any idea? Let's see. Every microservice will have a controller, is it not? So user controller is there. Let me add one default thing. How we do it? Default mapping. Only this much. Nothing. Let's say default. Any name I can give. Yahan pe hum message de sakte hain. Server microservices working. Server micro service working. It is giving some error. What is that? Let's see. Default is reserved, that is why. Default page, let's say. Okay. Default page. Now let's go there and click here. That is actuators info. Look here, we got microservices working, whatever the message may be. Okay, now my question is not that. My question is, I'm passing, now I'm just pressing. Just see here, guys. That portion you just see carefully. I'm just pressing register. See here what happens. Client is requesting to server. And after request, they look at this. Server returns some results. And that result is displayed in do register pay request. See here. Let me go back. अभी सबसे पहले यहाँ कौन सा दिख रहा है? ऊपर देखो URL 9090 register. When I press this, let's see the controller also. Then only you will understand the workflow. Main control model controller यहाँ पे देखो, है ना? Register. So when I say register and after saying register, this register view page is being displayed. From where? Register.jsp. Look at this. But when I say do register, what happens? Proxy for user register gets created, because client microservice create karne mein aapko yaad hoga structure ki the actual microservice jisko client ko communicate karna hai uske liye ek proxy server create karna hoga. That is nothing but a simple interface. ये सब हम लोग ऑलरेडी कर चुके हैं और वो हमने यहाँ पे एंड नाउ दिस टुडेज एग्जांपल्स में हमने दो अलग अलग माइक्रो सर्विसेज यूज क्रिएट किया एज अलग अलग सर्वर. तो जितने अलग अलग माइक्रो सर्विसेज को क्लाइंट के अंदर यूज करना है उतने नंबर ऑफ हर सर्विसेज के लिए एक अलग अलग प्रॉक्सी क्रिएट करना होगा. तो प्रॉक्सी को मैंने com.ph.mainmodule.proxy पैकेज के अंदर क्रिएट किया है. And that is why, लुक एट दिस, ये ऑलरेडी हम लोग कर चुके हैं सारे चीजों को, बस वी आर जस्ट यूजिंग सो दैट वी गेट द प्रैक्टिकलिटी एक्सपोजर. यहाँ पे दो फंक्शंस है ना, एक URL register और दूसरा URL register one. तो दिस इज वेरी सिंपल टू क्रिएट. व्हाइल क्रिएटिंग दिस प्रॉक्सी बेसिकली यू हैव टू रेफर टू एक्चुअल सर्वर्स कंट्रोलर. एक्चुअल सर्वर्स कंट्रोलर देख लो यहां पे है ना, एंड जितने ये तो हम डिफॉल्ट क्रिएट कर चुके, इसकी कोई आवश्यकता नहीं है. ये जितने फंक्शंस यहाँ है सारे फंक्शंस को उठा के कॉपी पेस्ट कर लो कहाँ पे, प्रॉक्सी के अंदर, एंड रिमूव द कोड एंड ऑल, बिकॉज हियर जस्ट यू हैव टू क्रिएट इंटरफेस. और इंटरफेस का नाम मैंने यहाँ क्या दिया है, प्रॉक्सी फॉर यूजर रजिस्टर. और यही प्रॉक्सी फॉर यूजर रजिस्टर का इंस्टेंस यहाँ पे हमारे पास मिलता है थ्रू ऑटो वायर. This is what is the beauty of Spring, that is called injection, that proxy for user register instance is created and injected at PS1 variable, instance variable. Now see here, this is basically an interface. तो इंटरफेस का कभी ऑब्जेक्ट बन सकता है क्या? नहीं. तो योर स्प्रिंग बूट व्हाट इट डज फॉर यू इज दैट इट क्रिएट्स क्लास फॉर यू, इंस्टेंशिएट्स, क्रिएट्स क्लास फॉर यू, इंप्लीमेंट्स ऑल द मेथड ऑफ दिस इंटरफेस, and then create object, and that object is instantiated, injected to this instance variable by, that is what is auto wired annotation. Look here, now through this we are basically sending request to users that another service. So by this request, basically by this statement, this client microservice is sending, requesting to serve another microservice, and that microservice result is being returned. And ये जो microservice जो result लौट आ रहा है as a string, एक second undo it. That result gets stored at MSG. So in order to understand this, let us discuss do register जो आपका है वहाँ पे controller. Let's see here. अब रजिस्टर कंट्रोलर ये कौन से मेथड को यहां कॉल कर रहा है, रजिस्टर्ड यूजर. अब इसके लिए आपको प्रॉक्सी को देखना होगा, इसके लिए आपको यू विल हैव टू सी प्रॉक्सी डू ps1.registeredUser. सी हियर, अब रजिस्टर यूजर को देखो, यहां पे कौन सा है URL, रजिस्टर्ड. So this should be the same as of server microservice. Of server microservice yahan pe kya return kar raha hai, gaur se dekho. Let's go to server, not this user control. Ye kya return kar raha hai, server, then server registration done. This is the result which is being returned by the server microcontroller, server microservice. So server microservice ye return kar raha hai as a string, and that is received at where? This MSG. और इस MSG को हम क्या कर रहे हैं? This is the new thing you might be seeing. Because this has to be viewed. So for that, a Spring framework has a model that is basically used to pass data to the view. So not like earlier, microservice is quite different here. When we are saying return post register, what does it mean? Do you know? It basically returns the post register dot JSP view. And that is why I had told you that go and check. यहाँ पे दिख रहा है ना पोस्ट रजिस्टर. सो इट इज नॉट ऑर्डिनरी माई क्लाइंट माइक्रो सर्विस. एंड ऑल्सो यू कैन सी हियर इट इज नॉट एनोटेटेड विथ रेस्ट कंट्रोलर. इट इज सिंपली अ कंट्रोलर. डू यू नो वॉट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन कंट्रोलर एंड रेस्ट कंट्रोलर? ऑल दिस पॉइंट वी हैड डिस्कस्ड बिकॉज ऑलरेडी आई हैड टोल्ड यू in the last session that we are going to integrate in a small application. Do you know when you have to annotate with controller? Simple, when you are supposed to create a view, that is you are having JSP file. In order to create front end where we shall use all those JavaScript, jQuery, HTML, CSS, everything. Just think of web page, complete page. There, that controller has to be annotated with controller annotations only. And REST controller means you are not creating any views, accepting the request, sending back the result. Accepting the request from client and sending back result to the client. So that will be REST controller. See here, user. Let me close certain. Look here, user controller has been annotated with REST controller. Because here it is not a view. When you are returning this, that means you are returning exactly the same string. Whereas in the main module controller, see here, when you are saying returning login, that does not mean that you are returning only login. What you are returning? Tell me.
JSP file.
You are returning login.jsp file. Aayi baat samajh mein?
Yes, sir.
You are returning login.jsp. And now, if in that JSP, if you want to display some logic, see here, yahan pe kuch business logic hoga. Yahan pe just see the line which I have highlighted. The server microservice returns something, and this MSG is content I want to send it to this post register, to this JSP file. That is service of the result returned by my one microservice is being passed to this JSP, that is view. Model view controller, इसलिए तो इसका नाम पड़ा guys. Model view controller. This is the model which is having all the data to be displayed. That data is being passed to this views, and the whole thing is controlled by using this controller. Yahi to hai beauty, layering of MVCs, model view controller. Ab now लेट आई विल शो यू हाउ. अब यहाँ पे ये एड एट्रीब्यूट्स, यहाँ पे कोई भी एट्रीब्यूट का आप नाम दे देंगे, एनीथिंग इन विद इन द डबल कोट्स, एंड दिस इज द एमएसजी वेरिएबल विच इज आई एम गोइंग टू एड टू दिस. सो दिस इन दिस मॉडल आई एम इंजेक्टिंग दिस एट्रीब्यूट एंड देयर वैल्यूज. And let me show you how this server MSG values is displayed using the post register JSP views post register. This is normal HTML file, but this is the line C here which I have highlighted. ये वहां जो आप लिखेंगे attribute में जो double quotes के अंदर लिखे हैं, that has to be enclosed within curly braces, and before that you have to put dollar sign. This is being translated by the JSTL libraries. We have already used those dependencies. So how easily, dekho, look at this, how easily is that model which was inserted is being used inside this views. तो वहां से जो लौट के आ रहा था ना, वही यहां पे दिख रहा था. आपको याद होगा मैसेज इक्वल टू समथिंग दैट इज वाज विजिबल टू मी. लुक एट दिस, दिख रहा है ना? इज दिस क्लियर? क्लाइंट ने कैसे रिक्वेस्ट भेजा, क्लाइंट ने कैसे रिक्वेस्ट भेजा, और रिक्वेस्ट को मैंने अपने कैसे साइट पे इनकॉर्पोरेट किया. आप देखते हो ना, इसका सबसे रियल एडवांटेज क्या होता है माइक्रो सर्विसेज का, कि इन स्पेशली व्हेन यू आर हैविंग ए कॉम्प्लेक्स ई कॉमर्स काइंड ऑफ वेबसाइट लाइक यू हैव अमेजोन और फ्लिपकार्ट, तो देर आर मेनी सेलर्स सेलिंग देयर प्रोडक्ट्स. नाउ सपोज यू आर क्रिएटिंग ए प्लेटफॉर्म ऑन विच मेनी सेलर्स विल सेल देयर प्रोडक्ट्स. अब नाउ If I am a seller, that means my information will be viewed. आपको क्या करना है? कुछ नहीं. That every seller will create their own microservice and they will pass you the interface to you. And now as soon as request from your software, that is website, is passed to that service, microservice of that client, and whatever the data it is returns, that is displayed into your views. Let me go. I am going to my home page. Let's register and see. I have also put register one. So ye to simply tha ki client is saying just hey give me that. Lekin another situation kya hota hai, client can say hey this is the roll number, you get me the result of that student. That means client is sending data to server. Yahan pe client is just requesting. To usi ke liye maine register one create kiya tha. Let's say I am just having one number and I am just pressing register one. Ab register one ke baad zara gaur karoge kya ho raha hai. This is another service. Nahi, sorry. This is another request to the same service. So that service is having two requests. Now look at this. The name which I had sent is being displayed here. Let me go back and Akshita, maybe whatever the spelling may be. Let's see. I'm saying to register one. Look, whatever the name was there, that is being displayed. तो ये माइक्रो सर्विस कैसे काम कर रहा है? माइक्रो सर्विस इज सेम, द रिक्वेस्ट अनदर रिक्वेस्ट दैट इज सर्विस नंबर टू ऑफ द सेम माइक्रो सर्विस इज बीइंग कॉल्ड. लेट्स सी, लेट मी शो यू. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सी द प्रॉक्सी एंड अनदर सर्विस के लिए मैंने यूआरएल नेम दिया है सर्विस वन. लुक एट दिस, हाउ वी आर पासिंग इंफॉर्मेशन टू दिस. आप उसके लिए थोड़ी देर के लिए आपको वो व्यू कोड देखना होगा. Let's see what is that view code. Here do register one is that what is that called? Do register, ignite back, register is the this thing URL, and for register what page is being displayed, this is. अब जरा इस फॉर्म को देखो गौर से. Here you look at this form 2 where the button is register 1. Are you getting? Form 2 is containing the button register 1. See here, the button is register 1. Okay? Let's see. Now it is having two fields. One is field name is, look at this, username is small mein likha hua hai. Dekho yahan pe God se. The first component name is username. And second component name is, what is that? Password. So first parameter will be passed as username and second password. And method I am using post. God se dekho. The method which I am using is post. So when I press this through post, this is being passed. So for that always you have to go to controller first. Let's see the controller. When I say do register, because once again, what is that? Server page, JSP page. And action kya hai? Do register 1. So in controller, there should be one URL named as do hyphen register 1. अब समझ में बात आई द वर्क फ्लो. तो डू रजिस्टर 1 रिक्वेस्ट यहां पे आएगी इस फंक्शंस को, एंड ये फंक्शंस क्या करेगा, दिस इज डू रजिस्टर 1 इज हियर. डू रजिस्टर 1 इज कॉलिंग टू अनदर फंक्शन, लुक एट दिस, विथ दीज पैरामीटर्स, username and password. But here, यहां पे importantly है through request parameter, the actual name you have to specify which was basically being requested. तो username देखो यहां पे small है, but here the variable वो हम Java convention से लिख रहे हैं. So the parameter which was requested through username and password, that is received at username and password as a string. And of course, lastly, always there will be a model. If at all you want to send any informations to your view, if you do not want to send information view, then you can remove this. So now what happens? I am calling the microservice to which this proxy is representing, and calling this method, sending this two parameter. That is why you can see proxy is requesting these two and received at actual. Look at this. Aayi baat samajh mein aayi? If any doubt, the workflow is very clear. Now this is handled. Now, because I never wanted to make it more complex, this is the goal of not this subject. Now here, hibernate name you would have heard, if you know those, and for that, on top of hibernate JPA, a Spring JPA has been created. So by using JPAs and all those concepts, database connecting can be done easily, or else directly by using, which already I had taught you guys. I had taught you many tools, many concepts beyond this Spring Boot. Because of getting the complete idea, if you could have done very seriously, that would have been easier for you. Database connectivity also have done. So forget a Spring JPA and all, which you, currently you can't say that I do not know, so you cannot do them. You can do those direct using JDBC and those concepts. Adding those dependencies, you can directly do the database connections code, and whatever the informations are there, they can be stored and all. So that is why I have just put the comment database and dot dot dot. So database line can be there, and the users can be users in informations can be stored at database. And now here, but just for testing, the kind of username which was returned, the same thing I am just injecting inside this statement and returning back. So that is why the server, whatever the client microservice is requesting to server, that information is received at this and returned back. The whole thing is returned back. Again, it returns back where? To the client controller. That is main controller. Look here. So whatever it returns, it comes here. Now that is I am storing at this microservice, and again I am calling post register. Got this? So post register, in for both the thing, for both the request, for both the URL, I am having the same views. So because of that, the post registered JSP ke andar, look at this. In user controller, that is server returns, comes to main model controller at this line. So this is what is called communications between two microservices. Client sends to request to server microservice, server microservice returns. And the server microservice task is only to receive requests and send back the response, and those kind of controller must be the annotated with REST controller. But the microservice controller, which has also to create views, that means they don't have to only perform request and response. Other than that, they have also to create views. They have to be the annotated, qualified with controller annotations. I baat samajh mein? Now, what is that? Post register will receive that and display this. So this is how the communications takes place. So these are calling basically two different services of same microservice. Now already I have also created one microservice. Let's go back to the client. See here, suggested link, and all this you have to create. Now I just added one simple template, any templates representing some figure and all. So that is the part of CSS design. That is not the part of, you can have nowadays, you can download any responsive templates, free templates are available, who is using all those stuffs. What you have to do is that only you add those CSS and all inside a static folder of. Now here, I am already using one more service, but I haven't started that service, and no fallback method is also used. That is why it is giving. But the better good designer need to take care of that. If that service is down, that means I'll show you controller, model, main model controller. See here, I'm requesting one request, two requests, and look here, there is one object of proxy for register one, another also proxy for microservice one. So because already I told you two microservices I am going to use, that is why there are two proxies. Every microservice, if my application is using suppose 50 microservice, then every 50 microservice has to be annotated, has to be created. For every 50 microservices, we have to create proxies. and all those, there must be interface for that, for URL for that, method for that. So this is another service. Now, as I said, because that service is down, so there has to be a fallback method here. You see the previous day's class, how fallback methods are used. So when that this service is nowhere available, that fallback method will be controlled, will be called automatically. And for that only Hystrix has to be used. I had already given, I have already uploaded that videos as well as the code also where we had used Hystrix. Thus, just it is a couple of minutes task. Just add those dependencies. The steps is quite simple. If you want me to show you right now, but before showing you, let me run that service, start that service and see what answers this is not coming. Let me run that service first. Let me minimize. And this is what is microservice one. This service is there, which I am to start it. Let's start first. During our tutorials, we used to run the services and ping on. This is running at 9092. You can check, but before that, here just refresh Educa server. See here. Look. All these three microservice. One is running. User register service is running. Main module is running. Now after this, if I click this, it takes some time. Let's refresh it. Look here. You got this message. It came, guys. So one client is using right now two services because there was no fallback method. If somehow this service is down, if somehow that service is down, the fallback method should tackle that situations rather than displaying it. So let me just down that service once. Microservice application, microservice one application is terminated. Service is down now. Press this. So how do you avoid handling Hystrix? How do you handle Hystrix? That step already we had demonstrated. Already we had demonstrated all those concepts in the last day. Look here, Hystrix already I had shown you. For this, what you have to do is that you have to just add these dependencies. And this for using Hystrix, you will not get at a Spring IO. So this is the dependencies what we have to add. Let me do it in front of you. Still, again, that will get revised kind of thing. So where? To the main module controller, because that is the main which sends requests. So it's a client. सो फॉर्म फाइल फॉर दिस लेट मी ऐड सेलेक्ट ऑल सो लुक and in this version is not at all needed. Why? You must be remembering all this will automatically taken care by our Spring Boots. Why this error is? Version for org is missing. It requires version. Let's give because it is not at a Spring IO. Okay, it is from external source. Now historic dependencies has been added. Only the thing you have to add the fallback method. Why and how? How fallback method has to be added? Using this line. That's all. So go to microservice controller. Main model controller. Look, I am adding right now. For every request, you have to add fallback method. Remember, guys. So this is how the thing has to be done. यहाँ पे इफ दिस फेल्स व्हाट हैपेंस मीनिंगफुल नेम वी शैल बी गिविंग मीनिंगफुल नेम फॉलबैक सर्विस वन फॉलबैक सो दैट we will not have any difficulties. See here. So whatever the method name you will specify, that has to be mentioned here. Is this clear? Now, because this service has failed, we don't have to call this. Some default message we will provide here. Kya likh denge? Currently, service not available. But why that is?
Sir, spelling mistake. मेथड डी आएगा लास्ट में.
अच्छा वो मेथड नहीं होगा यहाँ होगा. यस राइट यहाँ होना चाहिए फॉल बैक मेथड नॉट मेथड्स. ओके अब यहाँ पे देखो लिख देंगे करेंटली सर्विस नॉट अवेलेबल. अब मान लो इफ सर्विस इज डाउन दिस विल बी कॉल्ड तो यूजर विल नॉट गेट अगली पेज. तो ऐसा सबके लिए करना होगा. दिस इज द एडवांटेज ऑफ हिस्ट्रिक्स एंड दैट वॉज द लास्ट टूल्स विच वी हैड सीन. नाउ द सर्विस इज डाउन आई थिंक लेट मी चेक. यस सर्विस इज डाउन एंड लेट मी रिफ्रेश द पेज. And let's press this. What happens? Still it is displaying. that services go went off. Why that fallback method is not working? Let's see. Fallback method is okay. Service one fallback. Service one, ये name. This name, the fallback method name, which is applied to this history command, and this should match. It should be the same. Let me close all the services and restart. Is tarah se in this way we can create and do the integration. In this way we create one views and another services just as server, and the task of views ab yahan pe jitna acha css and templates we will use utna hi acha hoga. Ab when we are doing क्योंकि वो सर्विस तो डाउन है, सो दैट इज व्हाई इट इज नॉट एबल टू फेच. सॉरी, ये बंद है. नाउ टेल मी, हैव यू अंडरस्टूड अक्षिता?
यस सर.
तो जो टास्क जो दिए थे उसके बारे में आइडिया आ गई कि क्या करना है? वहां पे कोई डेटाबेस भी नहीं यूज करना है. अगर आप करते हैं देन इट इज वेल एंड गुड, अगर प्रीवियस नॉलेज को यूज करके. बट इन फ्यूचर फॉर यूजिंग ऑल दिस टूल्स प्रोफेशनली, द नेक्स्ट टूल्स व्हाट शुड बी लर्नड इज स्प्रिंग जीपीए. बट फॉर दैट ऑल दिस प्रीवियस कॉन्सेप्ट हैज टू बी क्लियर. जब तक हम स्प्रिंग जीपीए नहीं डालते हैं, व्हाट इज दैट बेसिकली? Those GPS and all Hibernate वगैरह क्या? That is basically your ORMs, Object Relational Mapping. So they basically creates map of your database as an object. So in one line you can understand the contents of database, that is tables, will be stored as an object for the Java applications. That boosts up the speed and performance of the applications. So that is interesting tools. But जब तक हम उन चीजों को नहीं पढ़ते हैं, directly the JDBC connectivity and all already I had discussed you guys in the earlier videos. You can see. So the applications what I gave you to create was currency conversions. So one microservice views will be there, which will create beautiful screen and interface. To that we shall enter the values, currencies, amount, and in the currency denominations in which we have to convert. When as soon as you press exchange or submit, the request goes to server. Microservice, that is another microservice. That microservice will accept, does the conversions, and returns the results. Now, for storing all the currencies values of different countries, you can suitably create a data structure at server end. May not be database right now. That is, you can create arrays or something like that in which you can store all those informations, all those parameters. They can be stored and return back the result to the client, and client will have their own views to display the result. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So already we have concluded, but the guys are not taking interest. What can I do? Systematically we completed all that. The things are, if one day you are not regular, slowly slowly the interest comes down. So there is nothing left for me to teach. Create this. If you have any problem, already code I had uploaded. There is no code new today, and the video file also after this class, because it is previous days video, whatever it will be, that also I shall upload. So once you, when you create, then only during creation you will face problem. You will do certain mistakes, then you will refer the videos, you will refer the codes. Because the code, whatever I have given, just download it and just import the folders all in your Eclipse, they will directly run without of any error. Okay, so you can try that and upload the project. When you have, if you have any problem, you can talk to me. Is that okay? Any question, any queries or any clarification, Akshita, do you want?
सर कहाँ पर अपलोड करना है प्रोजेक्ट को?
हेलो
सर, अपलोड कहाँ पर करना है उसको, असाइनमेंट को?
वो आपके इंस्टीट्यूशंस पे कुछ इंस्ट्रक्शन नहीं दिए गए
सर? हमें तो वो मिनी प्रोजेक्ट बोला था, वो तो मतलब अलग है ना चीज, ये तो अलग है आपका वाला असाइनमेंट, इसके लिए कुछ नहीं आ रहा।
कहाँ पे अपलोड करना था
वो तो सर अलग है, उसके लिए तो अलग फॉर्म वगैरह आया था, और उसमें भी आधे बच्चों ने GCCF वाला लिया था, तो उनको नहीं करना था।
अच्छा अच्छा, नहीं तो आप ये एक बार बना लो, वो सर से हमारी बात हो जाती है, तो मैं उसके जो लिंक होंगे सर डाल देंगे व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप पे, ठीक है ना? और अगर कोई दिक्कत होगी तो आप बताएंगे हमें, पर्सनली मेरी नंबर है, यू कैन टॉक टू मी, और व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप पे डाल दिया जाएगा, ठीक है? दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे।
यस सर।